Welcome to this video on how to do backtesting. After completing this, you will be able to list the steps for backtesting. Suppose you want to backtest your strategy, the first step would be to choose historical data. You can get this data from a data vendor or from your broker. It is important to select high-quality data. That is data without any errors. If you use poor quality data, then the output analysis from backtesting will be incorrect and misleading. In the price graph, you can see that the data has been selected for a period of 3 years. Apply the predictions from the ML model defined on this data to generate the trading signals. Let's say, as per the rules defined, you buy the stock around November 2014 at $24 and sell it around December 2014 at $30. Similarly, there were other trading signals also generated. The next step is to assess the returns of the strategy on historical data. You found that the strategy has given a return of 20%. But trading is not free. To get closer to the realistic results, you can incorporate the commissions and transactions cost while calculating returns. However, returns should not be the only metric to be evaluated. It is important to assess the risk as well. Metrics such as the Sharpe ratio and maximum drawdown should be used together with returns to evaluate the strategy. An important point to remember. It is not necessary that the past is always representative of the future. Hence, it is important to note that you should not over-rely on backtesting. For example, the COVID pandemic in 2020 was the first of its kind and had an impact on global markets. The rules identified on the historical data might not have performed well during this pandemic. To conclude, backtesting is a useful validation tool to evaluate the performance of a strategy. It increases the probability of identifying winning strategies. Therefore, it is also used by savvy and institutional investors to assess the viability of their trading strategies.